you should, yeah. Oh, gonna tell your name. Oh, gonna tell your name. Oh, gonna tell your name. Supports of episode 48 came out today because it's Wednesday, correct? Yes, it's Wednesday because it's the 7th, and my birthday is tomorrow, and it's the 30th. It's Thursday. I don't know why I said the 30th. I don't know why. Anyways, Supports of episode 48 came out recently. Literally today because it's Wednesday. That's the time of me recording this. Tomorrow is my birthday, and I might actually have another video up later today, hopefully, if I can get around to recording it, of course. I'm not going to tell you what it's about. I'm just going to say that if it blows up for whatever reason, it may or may not get a lot of negativity. So we're just going to have to wait and see about that. But anyways, we're here to talk about Boruto episode 48. And I actually didn't really mind this episode too much because it had a message to a lot of people who probably didn't see Naruto, Shippuden. And it's basically like, yeah, Naruto the Hokage at one point was a complete loser. He had nothing going for him, and now he's this all-powerful being who's stronger than basically everybody in the entire world. So, yeah, it's kind of a big deal. So the message is that, you know, as long as you have the determination to whatever goal you're trying to, you know, get to, like if you're trying to become a shinobi, if you're trying to become Genin, or if you're Genin trying to become Chunin, etc., etc., you know, if you try your hardest, you can get to it, and it doesn't matter about looking cool. You know, being a ninja, being a shinobi isn't about looking cool. It's about how hard you work for trying to get to your goals as a shinobi, and that's the whole message to it. And that's kind of like the whole message that the Naruto series as a whole has been trying to express to people, and that's what Naruto has been doing this entire time. His goal was to become Hokage as a kid, and it finally happened years later as he's an adult. So nothing else really of importance happened in the episode other than one of the members of like Konohamaru's like friend group back in part one and Shippuden. He's like way different. He's actually been in numerous episodes. I just couldn't tell if that was him or not, because like his character from part one as this nerdy little kid with like snot coming out of his nose isn't like there anymore. Like the snot isn't coming out of his nose anymore, even though he's still like sniffling, and that's like really gross. But in the episode he actually uses a jutsu revolving around it. It's kind of cool, but it's really odd. It's really odd. If I remember, I'll throw a screenshot. I hope I remember, but it's like really, really weird. I don't know how else to explain it. Think of it like ice release with like in the way that it looks, but then also, if you know what Chidori Nagashi is, that Sasuke has used in the past, think of it like that, because it's kind of like the mixture of both, but it's literally made out of the snot from his nose. It's like super weird, right? It's super weird. So Iwabe, Denki, and Metal Lee are all put onto a mission to do this Genin documentary, which is basically like supposed to like entice people to become a shinobi or work their way towards becoming a shinobi if that's what they want to do, obviously. So yeah, then and they just came out of suspension, and then Naruto kind of realized like, yeah, this is the perfect mission for them, blah 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 blah, right? I don't really know what else to say about the episode other than, you know, they go and do it. The director guy is like, oh, but you gotta do like cool ninja shit, you know? And they're like, yeah, let's do it. And then it like tears up a whole bunch of like houses and breaks like a couple of windows and stuff. And then Udon, I think that's what his name is, I'm not sure, I don't remember, but he's like, is it really that important to, you know, do cool shit as a shinobi in order for you being like a good ninja or something? And they're like, well, yeah, kind of, because of the situation that we're in, you know, to entice people to become ninja. And they're like, yeah, we're not gonna do this, because that's not the message that they're supposed to be getting. And then of course later on they kind of learn his backstory, and that's where like if like hardcore like Naruto fans, if they didn't like recognize him before, they know who he is now, and it's like kind of surprising, unless you picked up the subtle hint that like he's got like a stuffy nose and he's like and stuff like that. I didn't pick up on that. I was just like, what the fuck is wrong with him? And then he's like, yeah, let me explain my backstory. And I was like, oh, he's that kid? Oh, that's so dope. But like, what the fuck? How do you still have that problem with your nose, dog? What the fuck? So later on, the same director guy is like, all right, I need to get a couple of shots. And they place paper bombs in a building. It explodes. It doesn't really seem to do all that much. And then it starts crumbling down. And obviously, the three of them are like, okay, let's go help. And you're like, sure. So they do it. They save them. And then, like, they get, like, the whole thing, like, yeah, Shinobi, you don't need to be cool as long as you're determined on your goals, et cetera, like I already explained earlier. You know, that's all that matters. And they showed like bits and pieces of the documentary, and they show a couple of scenes of like Boruto, Sarada, and Mitsuki, and they're talking about like, yeah, we need to do this, yada 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 yada, right? And then they go into like this black screen where it's like, yeah, it was made by like these people of like this company or whatever. And then they have a little clip at the end of it, and they're like, yeah. And then Naruto is like, yeah. Now that I think about it, considering of what happened a lot in the time that I was like around, like as like a young like kid and stuff, I never really like took the chunin exams and passed like I should have, or how I should have already done. So technically, even though I'm the Hokage, if I wasn't the Hokage, I would currently be the most powerful genin in existence. And they kind of have like a freak out moment and stuff. I thought it was funny. I thought it was like a little thing at the end, because like Iwabe earlier was talking about like, ah, oh, I can't get held back as a genin, yada yada, because that's what he's like extremely scared of. He doesn't want to be held back, right? So, and then he's talking about like, ah, oh, I don't want to be getting whatever stuff, right? And then I was like, yeah, do they not know that like Naruto has been like a genin since like the first episode? Naruto's been a genin since the first fucking episode, and I'm just like, does no one else like really know that like whatsoever? I mean, I get it. I get that they don't know. But like, whatever. I don't know. I don't know what else to say about the episode, because there's not really anything else to talk about. The previews, I'm more pissed off about how bad next week's episode is gonna be instead of this week's episode, because I actually kind of liked this week's episode. It had a couple of moments that kind of made me laugh a little bit, and I like the message that, you know, it's like, yeah, you know this character Naruto, the Hokage. Everybody fucking loves him because he's like the most powerful like thing in the whole world. Yeah, he was a loser at one point too. He fucking sucked. He had nothing going from him. And you know what? You know what? He came out on top. He's the Hokage now, so fuck you. And I'm just like, oh, well, that's fucking cool. So whatever, right? I don't know what else to say about the episode other than I liked it. It was okay. It's not the best episode, but it's not the worst either. I think next week's episode, I'm just gonna be like really pissed. Like, oh, come on, just get to the fucking movie you're telling. So that way we get something at least a little bit interesting. But whatever, right? So I'm gonna try to get another video out today because I have a gripe with something that has become like an global phenomenon as of recently that a whole bunch of people have been making videos on for, it just seems like for no reason. Some of you may already know it, but I'm not, like I said, I'm not gonna say what it is yet. You're gonna have to wait for that video to come out. So anyways, I'm gonna stop stalling and just end the video right here. If you guys enjoyed, be sure to leave a like, and if you're new to the channel, please consider hitting the subscribe button for future videos just like this. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one. Hope you guys have a beautiful life. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next one, and I'm out.